Hi, I'm Brooks at Board Game Cavern. Today we're going to walk you through how to play Ravine, a 3-6 player cooperative card game. So grab a torch and let's head to the cavern. This is how you set up and play Ravine. You and your fellow passengers have survived a horrific plane crash. And now you must survive night after night until you are rescued. If at least one of you gets rescued, you all win. Otherwise, you lose. You're going to set up the forage deck after shuffling and the madness cards here in the center. Your fire is going to start as out, and then you'll put your spear, basket, and shelter cards here at the top so everyone can grab them. Everyone starts with 3 hearts, then give each player 3 more heart tokens, which they will go like dice, and that is your starting health, 2. So right now we have 4 health to start with. Every player will get a crafting guide, which tells you what you need to pay to make these particular items. Every player will also get 1 wreckage card, which tells you what they found in the wreckage of the plane. These are all unique cards that you can use later as items. Next, you'll take your knight card deck. You're going to shuffle it, and then for beginner, you'll take the top 8 cards. For normal, it's 12, and for difficult, it's 16. So we'll start with 8. Then you're also going to go find the rescue card. You'll take the bottom 3 cards from the knight card deck of 8 and the rescue card and shuffle those 4 together. Put that on the bottom, and that is your knight deck, which are basically your rounds that you'll have to survive. Now, you crashed at night, so the first thing you're going to do is turn over a knight card, and this affects everybody. Now, this one has no repercussions tonight, so that's great. An easy first night. You'll do a health check, see if anybody has just 1 heart. If anybody ever goes down to 1 heart, they have to draw a madness card, which can be pretty funny. Sometimes they have to hop on 1 leg or speak with their tongue tucked into their cheek or something like that. After all, it's madness. Hopefully, you've survived the night, because it's daybreak. Now, during the day phase, players can decide to stay at camp and do nothing, or they can risk hearts, and the number of hearts they turn over is the number of forage cards they will pick up. Then you'll grab that number, in this case 2, face down and bring them back to your camp. Nobody looks until everybody returns from camp. Then you're in the prepare phase, where you eat and craft supplies with your team to prepare for what the night may bring. So everybody flips these over. You don't have to show these to people, but it helps sometimes. Because you can decide, well, I'm going to give you the stone and we can build a spear. We have wood and stone. Wood and stone means a spear. So we can use these to build a spear, which can protect us from animals or such that might attack at night. Fend off 1 attack, breaks off after 1 use. This is also the time when you can eat anything you've found in the foraging. Now night has fallen again. We pull another night card. Nothing happens. If a character ever flips over their last heart, they are dead. But they can be revived thanks to the magic and mystery of the island. On this island, if you find 4 piles of bones, you can bring those back to camp, and you can spend them to bring a character back from the dead. If they come back from the dead, they start with 3 hearts, and all the characters that are still alive get 2 more hearts. You keep turning over knight cards until you get to the rescue. And that means everybody that's still alive after this horrible ordeal has been rescued. This is Ravine. I'm Brooks at Board Game Cavern. Thank you so much for subscribing, and we'll see you at the next one.
Cavern.